Here's another no-code tool you probably haven't heard of, and this one's a little bit different.
Okay, think Webflow, but for infrastructure, otherwise known as DevOps or no-code DevOps. So whether you're building a mobile app, a web app, or maybe even a website, you need a tech stack. At a minimum, most SaaS products will need some kind of backend, one or more front ends, and also one or more servers. A lot of people will set these things up using AWS, Azure, or Google Cloud. And typically developers will jump into like the AWS console in order to set up these different services. So OpsFlow actually allows you to build out your tech stack visually, then you connect your AWS account, then they configure your AWS account for you. They have a great little demo on their website. So let's say I need some kind of front end for my website. I need a server, I need a back end, right? And I'm gonna add a database. And I'm gonna click deploy. Now I'm not actually gonna deploy it because I'm not an engineer, but the feedback I'm seeing from developers about this tool is that it allows them to actually focus on building the product. They have feedback from developers who are saying, I've just spent a week configuring a server. Like, this tool seems too good to be true. And I don't know if it is, I'm not an engineer, let alone a DevOps engineer. But as someone working in product management and with developers every single day, I see how much time and effort it can take the team to set up basic infrastructure before we even think about building the actual product. Now, I did find another product that is trying to do no-code DevOps. So this indicates to me that there is a problem here that people are trying to solve so that developers don't have to spend as much time and effort and energy and complexity in building out the infrastructure for an application. Now, of course, there are going to be trade-offs and limitations and other issues that come with these tools. Is no-code DevOps going to do for infrastructure what no-code tools did for application and web development? I'm excited to follow this trend and kind of see where it goes and follow if you want me to keep you updated.